and I'm second year medical student. Is it right if I get the consultation today, please?
Yeah.
Great. Thank you. Can I ask you to confirm your full name and date of birth, please?
Yeah, I'm Sarah Rogers, and I was born on the 1st of January 1992.
And how old does that make you?
I'm 30 now.
Oh, great. Thank you. So what's brought you in today?
I've got like a rash on my calf.
Okay. Can you tell me a bit more about that, please?
Yeah, so I just got back from holiday, actually, visiting my husband's family, and when I've come back, I noticed it's gotten all red and swollen, and it's much bigger than it started off being, actually. So I thought I'd better come and see you.
Okay. And how long have you said that this has been going on?
It's got to be 3 days ago, I think, we came back. Yeah, 3 days.
Okay, and where did you go on holiday?
I went to Kenya.
And how far away is that?
Oh, the flight was about just under 11 hours, I think.
11 hours?
Yeah, it's a long flight.
Wow.
Yeah.
I bet you're quite tired now.
Exhausted.
Oh, my.
Yeah.
And during that flight, were you able to move about at all?
Actually, I slept for most of it. I didn't sleep very well when I was down there because of the heat. Not used to that.
Yeah.
So I slept most of the flight, to be honest with you. So I wouldn't say I moved around much.
Okay, and does it feel painful?
Not really.
And have you noticed any changes, any other changes to the skin?
No, nothing else. There's no. I thought maybe I'd infected it or something, but I couldn't find. There's no pus or anything like that.
Okay, have you noticed any bite marks or anything like that?
No.
Okay, thank you. And do you have any ideas apart from an infection that you mentioned that you think it could be?
No, I also thought I might have been bitten, but yeah, like you said, there's no bite marks or anything, so I've got no idea, to be honest with you.
Okay, and is there anything that's bothering you at all about your leg?
Well, to be honest, I haven't been able to go back to work since I've come back because of it, because they said it's not a good idea for me to work on my legs like this, so I just, you know, I really want to get back to work. That's really what I'm worried about the most. Yeah.
Of course. May I ask what you do for work?
Yeah, I'm a truck driver. Yeah, I've been doing it for years, because of my leg being like this, they said that could be a liability or something. So I shouldn't work with it like this, but yeah, I've been a truck driver for years.
Okay, and how do you find that?
Yeah, it's good actually. You know, I just started off doing it by chance really. It's not something you grow up wanting to do, is it? But yeah, I find it quite relaxing. I do enjoy driving.
And are you able to get any physical activity during the day?
To be honest, not really. Not since I started doing this. I've been, I used to run actually when I was a teenager. I used to run, but since I became a truck driver, because of the shifts that I'm doing, I'm working such long shifts, and they're absolutely exhausting. And you can imagine, after driving all day, the last thing you want to do is go out for a run.
Yeah,
so I don't actually know.
Okay. And it's alright if I ask you as well, what were you expecting, what were you hoping to get out of this consultation today?
Just want the leg to be fixed, to be honest, so I can go back to work.
Okay, that's cool. So can I ask you a few more questions about your personal life?
Yeah.
Okay? Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you. And do you know of any conditions that you've been diagnosed with?
Yeah, I've got high blood pressure, and I've got diabetes as well.
Okay, and how long ago were you diagnosed with diabetes? Do you remember?
Yeah, it was a couple of years ago when I got diagnosed with diabetes. They gave me a tablet for it, metformin.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And do you take any other medications?
Yeah, for my high blood pressure, I don't know. It's angiotensin, is that right?
Possibly an angiotensin receptor blocker.
Yeah, it might be that. Yeah, I can't remember the full name for it from this. But embarrassing because I've been on it for a while actually, but yeah, that's it.
Okay, and do you take any non-prescribed drugs that you can take, maybe that you can buy from the pharmacy?
Not from the pharmacy, but I get my pill, the the oral contraceptive pill. I get that from the sexual health clinic.
Okay, and how regularly do you take that?
I've been on that actually for a few years as well. I take it every month, just the way you're meant to, with a break at the end of it, at the end of the month.
Okay, and can I ask you a few questions that we ask everyone who comes in?
Of course.
Great, thank you. Do you use any recreational drugs?
I dabbled in it a little bit when I was a teenager, but I don't currently use any recreational drugs now.
Okay, great. Thanks for telling me. And have you ever smoked?
No.
Okay. And do you drink alcohol?
I don't drink alcohol, no.
Okay, great. And do you know of any conditions that run in your family?
There's no conditions. My mum, she did go for a surgery once. That was a while ago. I don't remember exactly what it was for though. But yeah, she had some complications from it.
Can you tell me a bit more about that, if you don't mind?
Oh, the complications?
Yes, please.
Yeah, that's why I remember she had the surgery, because they said she had a DVT.
DVT.
Oh, yes, yeah, yeah. She had that.
Okay.
But I don't remember what the surgery was for, so yeah.
Okay, and do you know of any other conditions that were in your family?
No.
Okay, great. And so I'm going to ask you a few more questions just so that I can rule a few things out. Is that okay?
Of course.
Okay, thank you. So have you noticed any changes in your skin, any other rashes anywhere?
No.
And have you noticed any changes in your waterworks?
No.
Have you noticed any changes in your bowel habits?
No.
Okay. And do you feel breathless?
No.
And do you feel any dizzy episodes?
No.
Okay, great. Thank you. And do you have any other symptoms at all? Do you feel well yourself?
Yeah, I feel fine. Yeah, I do feel fine.
Okay, so do you have any, do you feel warm at all? Any sort of temperature?
No, I would have noticed, no.
Okay, thank you. And going back to your, a few questions about your personal life, what's your living situation like?
Oh, I live with my husband. I got married about 2 years ago, so thank you. I just live with him.
Okay, that's the end of your station. Please can you answer the following questions now? Please can you present the case and list your differential diagnoses?
Okay, so this is a 30-year-old female who has presented with a unilateral red swollen calf that has been present ever since she returned from her 11-hour flight to Kenya, from Kenya. And this patient has not had any other symptoms of relevance. However, her mother has experienced a DVT in the past, and she currently takes the combined oral contraceptive pill.
So list your main differentials.
My main differentials include a deep vein thrombosis, cellulitis, and lymphedema.
Can you explain your differentials?
I would say that the deep vein thrombosis is my main differential diagnosis because it is a unilateral calf swelling that has been present ever since she returned from a long-haul flight. She takes the combined oral contraceptive pill, and she has a family history of a deep vein thrombosis, which are all risk factors for a DVT, and also she could have cellulitis because she has recently been to a foreign country. She could have been exposed to, for example, an insect bite, and lymphedema as well is possible because of the...
Alright, that's the end of your station. Thank you very much. You may leave.
Oh, thank you. Thank you for your time.